Hello, hello, hello! You're tuning into another episode of The Wunderkind Show. Today's second topic, Nick Wright has something to say about Lamar Jackson. Look, I've been really candid on this channel about the differences between Lamar and other quarterbacks and how they treat him compared to his, you know, contemporaries. I've covered it religiously, right? And I've always, you know, said, look, there is a visible difference between how they treat some of his guys compared to how they treat Lamar. And the crazy thing is that at this point, now it's becoming so overt that other people are starting to call it out. And not just call it out, he's putting his name behind it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to play the audio that Nick Wright said about Lamar. And then we're going to break it down. Because as Raven fans, as fans of football who respect the game, I think things like this have to be called out. So without further ado, let's play the audio and then we're going to break it down. Let's do it!
Lamar thing is almost has felt for his whole career a little more nefarious. There's almost a level of, it's not just that he's black, but it's that the way he carries himself and that he is so unashamedly himself that some people have been like, I don't want that guy to be the best play, the best quarterback in the league or the MVP in a level that other black quarterbacks didn't threaten them the same way, like Mahomes or other guys that they were like, okay, no. Yeah, that's more okay. So,
yo, hey, yo. And he said this on the Colin Cowherd podcast. He said this totally like, look, this is what's going on with Lamar. And Colin Cowherd's like, not even blinking. Let me make sure I say this too. This is part of the reason why I respect Lamar. Now look, when you look at it, he's a young man. He's giving something, he's giving everything he can to his craft, right? The level of vitriol placed against him makes no sense. And I want to make sure that I put it in the context to say it doesn't make sense. You have a young man that is not out there doing foolishness. He's doing something to make generational wealth for his family and to have a lasting legacy. Oh! And they seem to have a problem with that. Another thing that we want to make sure that we point out when it comes to this, right? He's intelligent. He understands things that usually make other people uncomfortable, right? Usually people don't like business savvy athletes. You know what I'm saying? They like athletes that look business savvy, but they have their agents handle the business. Shaquille O'Neal talked about this when he went into a room with executives and stuff like that. They wouldn't even talk to him directly. They would just talk to his agent or the guy that he was with. And O'Neal was just like, hey, yo, this is mad disrespectful. He's using my money. You know what I'm saying? Lamar does it himself. So I've always said that he upsets the balance of certain narratives because he represents everything that they hate. He's unapologetically authentic himself, which, as some people might understand, he's unapologetically black. You get where I'm coming from? He's not looking to be anything else than what he grew up to be. He has that Southern strong draw. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? So on top of that, he's outspoken, he's God-fearing, and he smiles. He smiles. So he doesn't fit the pictured narrative that they would connotate towards that image. You get where I'm coming from? Usually like, yeah, you know what I'm saying? No, it just kind of is what it is, guys, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's so smooth, and it bothers them because they can't, he goes out of the realm and the bounds that they're used to. And as humans, we all know people do not like what they don't understand. It's been historically proven. I wanted to cover this simply because I think sometimes he gets such unwarranted hate as Raven fans. And I'm not, and not just as Raven fans. We've seen people in the flock. The flock. The people who were supposed to be behind Tim more than anybody else. Pause. You got where I'm coming from? Everything that he does, they rip it apart. Listen, shout outs to my man Skeptical, right? I'm going to read something he wrote because this perfectly encapsulates exactly the point I'm trying to get across, right? If y'all don't know Skeptical, this is one of my boys. Amazing guy. He's on Twitter. I'm going to read you what he wrote on Twitter. And it's exactly what, imagine this. So, and this is what he wrote, quoted. So the media can admit that the offensive coordinator Lamar had his first 5 years is unemployable. His wide receivers he had to work with aren't in professional football. And that this year is his first year with an offensive coordinator has allowed him to be treated like an NFL QB. But the 1-3 shocks them, and it's all his fault. You ever heard of the word I always say, context? He's the only guy that never gets context around anything that he does. If he loses a game, it doesn't matter what goes on in the game. He's just supposed to win regardless of what goes on. It's the same thing that we covered with Shannon Sharp and his brother Sterling Sharp. Oh! And both of them deserve slaps because these two brothers came out there and said, oh, it doesn't matter whose wide receivers are. That shouldn't matter. Somebody was catching those touchdowns, right? Somebody was catching those passes, right? Whoever you take to the dance is who you got to dance with. They said. And on the same narrative, the same note, they said, Mahomes doesn't have the receivers he needs to be successful. Herbert needs more help. Lawrence's receiver should do more for him. Josh Allen needs more help. See what I'm saying? It's crazy when we get to the point to where it's like even former players don't make sense or don't even support because they're part of the establishment. Look, I at this point, I'm kind of tired of the old tropes and narratives regarding or circulating around Lamar all throughout every news cycle. But I will say this much. If he gets a Super Bowl, you see if that man hoists that Lombardi, he stands on that podium with two hands on that silvery object, glistening with the lights of the stadium, covered in confetti that matches the hues of the team that he plays for. Make no mistake about it. A lot of people are going to be erasing what they put out. They're going to be trying to change history. You remember how loud Doug Gottlieb was about him? Have you heard about Doug Gottlieb? About Lamar? You heard about him in the offseason. Oh, yeah, you heard him even the beginning of the season. But as the Ravens started racking up wins, he got real quiet. So much so he stopped covering football. That's what we're dealing with. But make no mistake about it, I will be calling it out anytime I see. You see that hatred, that vitriol that he has to go through? Don't worry. Regular media won't call a spade, but the Wunderkind Show will. The Wunderkind Show, yes, because we go there. We go there. Lamar, if you're watching this episode, go get your Super Bowl, bro. Go get your Super Bowl. I know you're not going to rub it in their face. You're not built that way. All you're going to do is stand on that podium. Thank all the people that have been there for you. You're going to thank God, of course. You're going to thank your superwoman of a mom. And you're going to thank your teammates and coaches. But that's why you got people like me. Ow! Because you know I'm going to be slapping them for you. But what do you guys think? Do you agree with me that the narratives are tired, worn out, but somehow they remain on rotation? Let me know what you think down in the comments section, because it has to be told. But as always, that's an episode of the Wunderkind Show. Thank you for watching. Y'all know how we get down. We have fun and we laugh. But everything we talk about rooted in what? Facts and truth. Please do remember, like, subscribe, hit that notification bell, leave a comment. You don't love the comments. And if you have not done so already, check out the Wunderkind Show's Patreon. Yes, 3 tiers of content goodness waiting for your consumption. Give it a look. Give it a try. Let me know what you think. And if you would like to donate to this channel, help out with equipment and stuff like that, bottom of the screen, QR code. QR codes to a Cash App. Cash App located in the description of every video that we do. And the name of it is Money Sign The Wunderkind Show. Super easy. But once again, this is The Wunderkind Show. This is your host, Nacho, signing off. And as always, you know my slogan. Peace. And I am out of here. Yeah.